Praise the Lord. Then step number six, you set what we call a deadline.
Grace to go for it again. God Almighty will give to you in the mighty name of Jesus.
This is your time. This is your season. I release it and go to sleep and prosper.
Asking smartly. You set a deadline. Why do you mean deadlines? Because if, for example, if I want to go to school, you don't just get back to school and say, okay, anytime I graduate is when I graduate. No. That's why I love schooling in this environment. I love schooling in the US. Unlike back home, you know when you enter school, you don't know where you are graduating. Right? In this place, where you enter school, you know when you are graduating. If all things be equal, you don't repeat any class. You know when you are graduating. You can begin to plan your graduation. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So you set a deadline. You are trusting God for something. Then put deadline with it. And if the deadline passed and that thing you are trusting God for has not materialized, extend the deadline. You keep putting, but it helps you to walk towards something. Praise the Lord. It helps you to walk towards something. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Then step number seven. We're looking through, I believe it's second hymn, but yes, this is what you need to start your year. It's not to destroy enemy, to kill enemy. Enemies will be there. Either you kill them or you don't kill them, they will be there. But you need to design your life. So when you design your life, and you don't design any enemies to be in it. So when you now see anything that was not planted by your Heavenly Father, you quickly recognize it that, maybe when I was sleeping, behold, enemy has come to plant this. Then you begin to what? Uproot them. Praise the Lord. But you did not plant, you did not prepare, you did not. So when you see anything, you just think it's part of the package. Praise the Lord. Step number seven. Step number seven, identify the what? Obstacles. Your desire, what you are trusting God for, okay, there will be some obstacles in achieving it. And somebody will say, Pastor, what do you mean? You need to identify ahead of time. For example, you get married and you want to be in love with your husband. Just me and my husband. Then some people, the obstacle they will begin to identify will be maybe their mother-in-law or their sisters-in-law. I remember one time, long time ago, my younger sister, we were talking, and she said, honestly, I don't want to marry any man that his mom is still alive. I said, why? He said, because most mother-in-laws, they are just something. I said, well, it is well. You are a woman, and by the time you now have a child, maybe somebody that wants to marry your child without saying, I wish I don't marry somebody that is or her mother still alive. Praise the Lord. No! When you know the kind of obstacles, then a wise woman will plan that as part of the word package. You don't fall in love with just the man alone. This is the word of the elders. You don't fall in love with the word with the man alone. It is written in the book of elders that the person that will not be able to be full, you prepare his home with your food. So even before you go to the altar, you settle it in the place of prayer, number one. Then you ask God for wisdom to deal with such a woman. Praise the Lord. You ask God to give you wisdom. You prepare food, fufu, etc. In Africa, do you eat fufu? You don't eat fufu. Okay, don't worry, I'll tell you more about it. Fufu is only something you put in your hand, you round it. You can use it, you can use spoon with it. We will call it fufu. Now, if you give your husband one meat and your mother-in-law is in the house, call me to visit. And you know this mother-in-law will be an obstacle to you having your movie night with your husband and this and that. Do you know what to do? You give her two meat. Then you give her juice. Then you have the juice plus wine, red wine. Then that the mama will finish it and go to sleep. So when she sleeps, praise the Lord. When she sleeps, then you resume your movie. Praise the Lord. The Lord Almighty will help us in Jesus' name. And the Lord will help our mothers to know that this child, you give back to the child. But now, this boy is a grown-up. This girl is a grown-up. Allow him, allow her to enjoy her home. But some of our mothers still want to invigilate, they still want to supervise. You laugh too much, especially when they live with you, they come. All this way, I heard you guys laugh. What concerns you? Husband and wife, they are laughing. What is your home? If they are crying, what is your home? Stay in your room, they give to you. And stay in your own name. Praise the Lord. So, identify the obstacles. Some, you want to do something, the obstacle might be money. You want to start a business. And you analyze how much you are going to start with. The obstacles you identify might be money. When we were coming to this place, and of course in the church back account there was nothing there, one of the challenges we had was what? Money. And I took pen and began to draft, map out different strategies. And remember this, Tadoyosu was calling of people, lenders that would loan us money. And we came up with different options. You need $10,000 to start something. The fastest way to get $10,000 is to look for 10,000 people to give you $1. Right? Maybe that would be too stressful. Then you can take it ahead, look for what? 100 people that will give you how much? $100. If 100 people give you $100, you have 10,000. Okay, you don't get that. Okay, look for 10 people to give you $1,000. 10 people. Okay, that is too much. Then look for how many? One person that can just out of annoyance give you check on 1,000 or 10,000. You can break it down. Do you know some of us will be praying, God, make me a millionaire? Do you know why it's very easy? One day I said that I know it's very easy to be a millionaire. All you need to do is find solution to a problem that 1,000 people will pay you $1,000 to solve. Right? You have solution to a problem and you present that solution to people and they pay you $1,000 in exchange of the solution. So we identify obstacles that you will have. This is what stops people. You can see it's a barrier. A lot of people have goals. A lot of people want to make heaven, trust me, but there are obstacles in making heaven. One of them is affairs of this life. So when you identify that, then you know yourself. You don't go where you are not supposed to go. You are a man and you know that anything under skirt makes you to, it can make you to lose salvation. Then close your eyes when you see anything under skirt. Just be looking at man. Praise the Lord. And you know that, okay, you want to make heaven. Yours is money. And you are working in a, and you say you want to go and study finance, and you want to work in the bank, or you want to become accountant, and you know that you have problem with money. Identify obstacle. Please don't go. Just go and do nothing or medical that you deal with God. Human being, you cannot see human being. So you just go, you just be dealing with papers. You don't handle physical. Praise the Lord. Identify what? The obstacles. By God's special grace, we are trusting God to grow us as a church. What will be one of the obstacles? Our culture. Praise the Lord. Culture. The way we treat people. The way we talk to people. The way we handle people can be chasing people away. So, when you notice that, you have to begin to work on it. Praise the Lord. People like, black Americans, like Caucasians, like Indians, Chinese, they cannot come to church and all what will be singing will be KBSU. You will chase them away. Obstacles. There will be time to sing it. But there will be time to what? Flow with them. Obstacles. Identify the obstacles. I went for a training and the man of God that was teaching us that you have to even identify the kind of people you put in every department. Can you imagine a sister that doesn't know how to laugh, how to smile, how to welcome people, and she's now standing as usher? She will be the one that will chase people away.
Wow, 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 wow. I believe you have been mightily blessed from today's ministration. And my prayer for you is your blessing will remain permanent in the mighty name of Jesus. Do me a favor, share this video with your loved ones on Facebook and on WhatsApp, okay? You can also subscribe to this YouTube channel if you are watching this video on YouTube. And make sure you follow us on Twitter and like our Facebook fan page. We will be glad to have you follow us everywhere we go. You can also search on your Google App Store and download our apps, okay, so that you can go with us anywhere you go. God bless you as you do this in the mighty name of Jesus. And are you there? Maybe you find yourself in our neighborhood. We'll be glad to have you worship with us. We are located at 3603 Shepherd Lane, Bow Springs, Texas. Zip code 75180. We'll be glad to have you. God bless you as you come in the mighty name of Jesus. Are you there and God is leading you to support this ministry, either the social media ministry or even to support the church? God Almighty bless you as you do this in the mighty name of Jesus. You can mail in your check to the address given before, or you can just visit on our website, rccg.org/donations. Your donation will get to us. And God of heaven will bless you as you do that in the mighty name of Jesus. Until next time on this program, Abundant Grace Hour. Remember, His grace is sufficient for you. Amen. Hallelujah.